What's going on YouTube? Flopfish here, and I'm bringing you a nice little quick tips and tricks video. I guess it's not going to be that quick, but it's going to be an entire period here. Once again, I'm using the Oilers, my favorite team in this whole game, because Sam Gagne is an absolute monster, and when they get RNH back in their roster, well, yeah, I like beasting with them because they have a lot of good right-handed shooters, and that's my specialty. That's the first tip is for puck possession. You're going to probably have a favorite handed player, and whether that's right-handed because you're right-handed or left-handed because you're left-handed or something along those lines, you're going to have someone that regardless of who it, like no matter what team you play on, you're just going to be better with that player. The reason why it's right-handed for me is because I shoot right-handed in real life, and it's just a lot easier for me to kind of see the ice in this game, quote-unquote. But I scored a couple goals with left-handed players in this game, ironically. It's just what you're comfortable with. You tend to find off that you'll pull Dekes, you'll have more confidence, and I'm starting to get a little more confident in my left-handed skaters, but I got really weak start, really bad goal to start it off. So when someone scores like that on you, the best thing you gotta do is you gotta have a bounce back shift, and he, I guess, paused the game to watch the replay. I don't know why, but yeah. But as for that first tip, you wanna generally get used to one-handed and then try to work yourself back into the other hand so you're able to play both right-handed and left-handed, like, from and see the ice in different ways and be able to deke, and you will be better with one. Like, I'm better with right-handed coming down the middle, going to the backhand forehand top corner. That's my move that I tend to score a lot of my goals on, and you'll see me do it a couple times in this game. I don't score on it, but I come close, and it works well for me. But the next little tip is line changes. I don't pull them off in this game, but there's something that is kind of funny. Nothing's really been said about this, but what you're going to notice in most games is that your lines roll 1-3-2-4 or 1-3-4-2. That means your second line is one of your last lines to go out. And in this game, your line refreshes a lot faster than the changes are. So realistically, you can go 1-2-3-1-2, and that's the period for you. Now, you gotta learn just to do manual line changes. So it's X, I believe, for your offensive, and A for your defensive. Is it A or B? I forget what one. I think it's B, which is square and circle on a PlayStation controller. But it's something that you don't really think will help out a lot, but it does when you have, say, a line of really skilled players. Like, say you were on Pittsburgh and they had Crosby still, and you had Malkin and Crosby and whoever else is on that line. You could throw up Jordan Staal on that line, and you could play them for three quarters of the game, and they'll still be fresh a lot. So what you want to do is you just want to tap X whenever, and you'll see the stamina, and generally wait till they're in the second to last green bar. When they're there, you call for the line change, because by the time the players skate to the bench, your team will be in full kind of update, or full legs, full stamina. So you'll be able to skate faster, and you can generally catch your opponent off guard. Just something I noticed from playing, something that's helped me out, so I figured I'd share that with you guys. And that's really it for this. One last thing I'll cover is puck possession. And the main reason to keep puck possession is to read what your opponent does, and they generally have a certain pattern. So this guy, when I got close to the boards, he tried to hit me. When I was in open ice, he tried to dive or drop down on one leg, and he tended to do that, so I could vary my breakout around that. And when you're doing your breakout, don't just skate in the same pattern over and over again unless it's wide open every single time. Try to vary it up a little bit. Like, you'll see me get stuck in the middle a couple times, so then I try to take it outside, and you'll see him keep on trying to go back in the middle over and over again, and it doesn't really work for him. Like, see, he keeps on going to the middle, and he gets the odd chance here and there, but it's also a lot of risk and reward for him, right? He always takes it to the middle, so I just knew to defend the middle. And right here, you'll kind of see me vary it up, and I get a really good chance skating around. And you can kind of see I made that first move. I made my move before he did, and the minute I did that, he dropped down. So it's kind of anticipating what your opponent's going to do. And I was anticipating him dropping down or laying out so I could kind of move around him, or so he'll change directions. When you're defending, you're in a major down, like, way harder position to get the puck than when you're offensive. You're such a big threat offensively if you know how to play with the puck. It's a lot harder to defend in this game than it is to play offense. I'm sure a lot of people will tell you that. And the last thing I got asked about was deking. I don't do a lot of dekes. I try to maybe do, I'll do a lot more one-on-one dekes now. I find they work really well, and that's a really nice goal from the grinders, but I'll try to do a lot of one-on-one dekes. I won't do a lot of curl and drags. I'm starting to do them and get better at them now, but as he flips that puck over, he rage quits, and I get the 3-1 victory in the first period. Another first period rage quit, but I really don't do a lot of one-on-one dekes, or a lot of, like, skill dekes like toe drags, stuff like that. I'm trying to now, and when you pull them off, it's pretty cool. But I love doing the nice little one-on-one dekes. The reach out to the left side of your stick, and then L1 or left bumper, I'm pretty sure, and then over does a nice little windmill deke, and I pull off a few of those and get some nice goals. But anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this and it helped you, and if it did, please leave a like. Thanks, bye.